with Peter Santinello. Right now, we in Compton.
The project, 700 West North Street.
This place has history.
Big history.
Guys were saying if I pulled in alone, there could have been some serious issues.
Oh,
how you doing? The fights take place back here.
Black mat, right here.
You ready,
yeah.
Is this Crips, this area?
That's Crips.
He's a blood. Peter.
Stay in your lane.
Stay in your lane.
Stay in your lane.
Gotcha.
Incoming.
Muchas gracias.
No matter your race, you just gotta support the people. You know what I mean?
Do you get along with the Chicanos?
How was that?
Silver alert.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hola. All you hear on the media is everyone's divided. Your cash is a superstar.
Just because we agree with something and you don't make you a racist. Let's go to your skin.
Miss Lim, is that the right one?
This is girl shirt.
From Compton, we don't use no K's on the front of our C's.
Peter Santinello.
Y'all know how we do, man.
Let's get it.
Turn me up a little bit.
I've been repped by the officials.
All right, guys, here I am with Cash.
BK Cash, man, we're back again, yeah, with Peter Santinello. But right now, we in Compton. Park Village, I got my boy Nuki Loke with me.
Nuki Loke, y'all.
We about to show y'all Compton's finest.
We have reconnected, BK Cash and I. We got together in East New York.
Yeah.
Now Cash goes from the east to the west.
Yes.
We're going in deep on Compton.
Deep at Compton.
New is the OG here. Is that fair to say?
This boy out here. This is the project, 700 West North Street.
I met this guy and we just...
We connected.
Connected. And he put me on. He told the whole hood, I'm family. Everything Gucci and since then. It's been like my second hood, man. Shout out to Brooklyn, East New York and everything. But right now, we in Compton.
So the guys were saying if I pulled in alone, there could have been some serious issues.
Your pockets would have got tapped.
It's very territorial out here. Very territorial out here.
Do you have Chicanos here?
That's black owned.
That's black owned. That's nice.
Everything over here is black owned. These are my boys right here.
How you guys doing?
Yeah.
How you doing?
Peace.
Peter, nice to meet you. How you doing? Is it okay if I roll the camera, guys? Is that cool with you guys?
Yeah, you good.
All right.
Watching a football game.
You guys betting on this?
Yeah.
Dude, I don't follow football. I don't follow. I know who you're going for.
Yeah,
just got me an OE. You know what I mean? That's what we do in Compton.
You like the English, huh?
Yeah,
I haven't seen one of those in like 100 years.
Pour a beer over there.
Old English. It's got a pretty big hop, doesn't it, Cash?
Yeah.
Everyone knows everyone.
Yeah, it's a big, it's like a family. We all family over here.
You guys
here.
Get along?
All of us.
Really?
I mean, we have fights, you know, amongst each other.
Sure.
Shake hands after that, maybe go get a bottle and drink, celebrate.
Right.
You know, to make peace.
This building knows this building knows this building.
All buildings know each other.
So you're talking 1,000 people?
More probably
more than that,
2,000-3,000 people.
What you got on the Rams?
Whatever this.
So we got a big game today, the Rams in San Francisco, and we got some serious betting going on.
At least about $10,000-$20,000 out here just on betting.
You guys all grew up together?
Yeah, from the sandbox. Just seeing, throwing at each other.
How old are you now?
40 years plus.
First, I was in a wheelchair for like 2 months.
From what?
From this bike right here.
Oh, wow.
700 blue thing right here.
You guys ripping these on the streets here?
Yeah.
Is that legal? On the streets? Or they just don't care?
Well, the police used to, like, pull you over, jack you, and take your shit.
But now, it's going on so much.
It'd probably be like 500 to 1,000 people on bikes. They call it the takeover. You know what I mean? From here to like Santa Monica, Hollywood, all that.
How is the neighborhood these days? People said it's a little hot right now. That's what I heard yesterday.
Hot, yeah. Like what you mean? Like the weather?
The Chicanos. No, in East LA, we're saying the crime's up a little, spiking.
Oh, yeah. Most definitely. Like for robbery or just...
I'd say inner beef in the hood.
That don't stop.
Is this Crips, this area?
That's Crips. Yeah.
This is Crips. Yeah, so everyone's Crips here?
Yeah, everybody.
Okay.
Not everyone. Not everybody. See that? We got one blood over there. I brought him to the neighborhood.
Yeah. There you go. He's coming over.
He's a blood. So
I brought him over here. I brought BK Cashmere over here.
But he's still a blood?
Yeah. He's a blood.
How you doing, man? Yeah. Peter.
I'm Jeff.
Nice to meet you, Jeff.
Well, they call me Bo.
Bo.
Yeah, one of my partners.
So you're blood, right?
Yeah.
And it's cool with the Crips here.
Yeah.
No issue.
I brought him to the neighborhood. At first, he didn't want to come over here because you know how it is over here.
Right.
You know, you hear the stories. I'm not coming in. He welcome. He came in, now he family. Like, he pull up without me now.
Is it different over here?
A little bit. Just a little.
How are they different? Is it like...
Stay in your lane.
Gotcha.
I met BK Cashmere through him.
Through him.
You know, you got people down here and people up here.
There's a hierarchy.
Yeah.
And how do you get to the top?
30, 40 years.
There you go.
I moved here when I was about 19 years old. I've been here ever since. I had to go through the bush, biting and, you know, all that. If somebody move over here when we're kids, you get a manager, like, oh, we got a new victim. Let me see if I can rob him, or let me see if I can beat him up, or...
Right.
You know what I mean? And if you accept it, you're known as a buster. You know what I mean? A punk. Like, oh, he outside again, let's go get him. I stood my ground, you know what I mean? And they set me like, oh, we want him from the hood. Mm-hmm.
So you stood up to who was above you?
Right.
And then you proved your authority, right. And everyone respects
that. Two guys, actually.
Everyone respects that.
Man, I went from there.
Okay.
If you get your pockets checked and you do like this, let a dude go in your pocket,
You
got. You're a victim. Every time we see you, I don't give a fuck if you going to the store, to school.
Pockets.
You know what I mean?
Pocket check.
All right.
Since
82. I don't have much. You know I got some batteries.
If you let a motherfucker, what you got? What you got in your pocket?
Stop touching my pocket.
You know?
Are you still that guy, Newt?
Nah.
When'd you stop touching pockets?
I stopped when I got life in prison, when I came back home.
Are you still doing that bullshit?
You got life in prison, but you got out.
I got caught up with the homies. I had got caught. They gave me 35 to life. I was in Folsom doing my time. And I came home on the appeal because, you know, I'm going to be there or dead type shit. So I was like, I still, you know, I'm in the bush. Like, you know what I mean? But if it come to that.
Right.
You know what I mean? But other than that, I do this. I bag up.
You don't initiate.
Not no more.
Okay. Did you guys ever beef, you and Cash?
No.
Nah, never.
Nobody beefs with this guy, though.
He's cool. He's like,
I don't like him sometimes.
We went back and forth sometimes, but nothing serious.
Yeah, you heard his latest music, though?
Yeah.
I love his music. It's bomb. Yeah. So all the music, guys, in this video is from BK Cashmere. It's a nice truck.
Nice.
He doesn't take that off-road, does he? So you guys are really into your lowriders.
Yeah, lowriders.
Do you get along with the Chicanos or not so much?
Yeah.
Because they love this stuff.
Because when we go out and ride, like Crenshaw area, Maine and Compton and wherever we at, they there. We there.
Yeah, I got to say, it's really a nice SoCal thing in the culture, the lowrider. It doesn't work anywhere else like it works here. You know what I mean? You can't do this in New York. It's not the same.
We have two projects in Compton, and they both Park Village. This is the Wilmington Norms, and the other side is original Park Village. But we all one hood. The only projects in Compton.
This place has history.
Big history.
Was it pretty bad at one time?
Oh, really bad. When I brought BK Cashmere, my blood partner, they didn't want to come over here. Like, man, I'm not going over there.
Crazy.
When did that stop? When did it stop being so bad?
When the feds came through and raided back in the day, it kind of like slowed up.
Okay.
It was still bad. It's still bad now.
Don't get
me wrong.
Okay.
It's still bad now.
And I'm only good because I'm with you.
Yeah, you good. You see how they welcome you?
Yeah, everyone's cool.
Now, like I said.
So that's really how it works in these areas. In Compton, it's like who you know.
Mm-hmm.
What your association
what you know
is
who you know.
It's who you know.
It's who you know. Yeah.
And it's like family.
Yeah.
And it's gang, right?
Yeah. I mean,
to some degree.
Gang culture,
but not everyone's in a gang. Some people are in a gang, but in a sense, it's like everyone's connected.
Yeah.
So I was thinking this, and my wife was asking this. She's like, how do people move from the hood outside? Because in the video we shot, she's like, everyone seems so connected. They have their culture there. They have their friends. Every apartment knows every apartment.
Right. Mm-hmm.
How can you go to another neighborhood where you know nobody?
It's kind of, it depends on the, like, it depends on the beef and who's the enemy or not.
Like, I can't move in like a hood that I'm beefing with somebody.
But what about this? What if you were to move in like a one bedroom apartment by yourself in Santa Monica?
Oh, you good. I know.
But would you want that? Wouldn't it be, you wouldn't have your friends around?
No, you want that. You want your peace and quiet, you know, your time alone. And when I want to get rowdy or hood, I come to the hood, hang so out, drink.
You dab in, dabble out.
Yeah.
So we was in Hollywood yesterday partying with the stars.
We got to put on Black Mat. This is where the action happened at.
Okay, what do you mean by that, Black Mat?
Be from the neighborhood, they get socked out, you know, beat up.
Okay, so you're saying the fights take place back here?
Black Mat, right here. What it is, like say, he been over here, a few years, and he's like, man, I love pork business, I want to get put on. Black Mat.
Yeah.
You got to get on his mat and get his ass whooped.
Or whoop some ass.
How many times you been on the Black Mat, Cash?
I haven't been on the Black Mat.
You're not from
I have to. I have you re- to.
You,
re-
you ready? You ready, Cash?
Yeah. You want to get on the Black Mat?
I did taekwondo like when I was 12. And the Black Mat's got like the spongy.
Like
good,
like a cushion type.
Sort of like a boxing ring. And
say me and my homies got a problem with each other.
Come back here and settle
it. And we arguing like, what you saying? What you saying? Black Mat. You already know what it is.
Is it still carrying on with the younger generations?
Yeah.
It's still going.
Yeah, that's the most. I don't do Black Mat no more. If one of the young homies disrespect me or something like that, one of the other young homies be like, you dissing the big homie.
Yeah.
What's up with you?
Right.
Nigga, what you saying? Black Mat. We come right here.
Squabbling
and I can just like, you know, watch.
So no guns here. It's just fists.
Just fists. But after that, shake hands.
Okay, so there's a respect to it.
Yeah.
It's like a hockey fight, sort of, right?
Basically,
you punch and then perfect. You almost respect
perfect,
the person.
Yeah. Perfect example.
You shake hands, they roll up a blunt, go get a bottle, drink.
And then the order is established.
Yes.
Whoever won the fight now is higher rank, right?
No, you don't get no rank like that.
Okay.
Not just by no fight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You need time.
It's history years and you gotta develop. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they're not just going to give you the trophy just like that.
No participation trophy?
Just say you want to fight.
Out here, it's totally different from New York. Like, it's an order. That's why I kind of like it.
Wait. So East New York doesn't have an order like here?
Like, nah. Out here, if somebody get out of line, somebody is allowed to check them. Out there in New York, they disrespecting the OG somewhere. Out here, that's not gonna fly.
Thought it would have been the opposite. I thought it would have been more old school over there.
Here is a gang culture. It's a hierarchy. Out there in New York, gang culture is getting very popular out there, but it's not. They're not doing it sort of like how they doing out here. He had to teach me how I was out here. I was out of line, you know what I mean?
I had to say so.
I was out of line, so I had to respect,
respect
him because he's the one who put me to be here. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it was like I had to respect it. I didn't know the politics. Now I do know.
Yeah.
So now you move in an orderly fashion. But it's structure out here. It's good structure.
Because I can tell, like, if two of the homies getting into it, one of them say Black Mat, I got the power to say no.
Yeah.
You can say no to Black Mat here?
I can squash it.
Yeah.
Wow.
You know, I can say, nah, y'all ain't going to Black Mat. Y'all talk that shit out.
Have you ever done Black Mat?
No, he's not.
Peter. What's your name?
D1.
D1.
Rap artist.
Got... What's your take these days as you get older? You want less black mat or
less,
want more?
Yeah. Less.
Okay.
Less.
Okay.
Because it's not worth it sometimes.
Yeah.
You know, y'all arguing over a football game. Today is going to be arguments.
There's a lot of money on the
better
line.
Better than me.
Yeah.
I mean, he should have did this. Like, man, and then somebody might shut up. Right. We go through the gate right here.
Right. So let's get
as you can see, they cut the gate down.
Yep.
So when the kids can go straight from the projects into the park.
Cool.
The homies be dunking and tearing shit down.
Man.
That's why this side missing.
The good thing we don't have a basketball, Cash. I'd have to show you my moves, man.
Yeah, the homie redid this shit. The homie Big Rock had it painted and stuff.
It's pretty well set up.
We have football games, picnics, everything.
Big nights.
Movie nights?
All
they set up a screen right here, a little inflatable.
Who's they who sets up the screen?
Oh, the big homies,
whoever.
Sometimes the mayor come over here and, you know, set something up.
They had a Thanksgiving drives, Christmas drives over here, passing out toys and, you know, for the kids.
We gonna go get some Louisiana chicken right there on the Alondra. The Peter Santinello. Y'all know how we do, man. Let's get it.
We saw a family. If I need help, maybe paying my rent, getting my car fixed.
Getting the car fixed.
A couple guys are coming together.
If you need money, like somebody say they need money, like I'm not even from here and I naturally do it. Like, I need $10. I come out my pocket and give them $10. It's different in New York. Like, people would be ashamed to ask one another for $10, $20.
Nah, we help each other.
You know, out here, nah, because it's a gang culture, it's a whole different culture.
Right now we at the Louisiana Hood spot with a good chicken at. I've been coming here for like maybe 30 years or more. That's the Hood liquor store. We go get our liquor, meat, you know, whatever, Miracle Market.
Okay.
You know what I mean? That's the other side of the project right here. That's our other project right here, right across the street.
Gotcha. So this is the go-to place for food?
The go-to place. One of them.
A couple of fries. Yeah, we have. Yeah, let me get a breast combo.
We're going from the chicken stand to right across the street to get something to drink.
Miracle Market.
Compton Airport. Across the street from the neighborhood. Right there.
That's not commercial, is it? It's like a private airport?
It's like, mostly private. You can go get you a plane and do what you want to do. That's the famous Miracle Market right here.
Yeah.
Why is it famous?
Because it's been here forever. Yeah. My homies worked in here. Look, I got one of my homies right here right now. Come on. That's the homie from the neighborhood right there, Blue, Psycho Blue.
And I'm the candy house lady from the neighborhood.
Yeah, she's the candy house lady.
You got some good chocolate?
Yeah.
That's my jam.
That's the homie Heavy D. He from the neighborhood.
Heavy D.
Raider Nation too. Recognize the face. One of a kind.
He from the project.
He's got that Hollywood look.
Like a lot of people they're just breathing the breeze. You know, like me, a person like me taking care of my kids is like breathing. Like something that you're supposed to do anyway.
Right.
If you have them, you're gonna have to figure out a way to do it. A lot of people just feel so entitled. And that's where the fakeness, because they trying to keep up with stuff that doesn't even matter. They're trying to keep up with the person with the newest sneakers, the newest car, this, that, and the third. You know, not knowing, all you gotta do is put yourself a plan together, and all of that's gonna come with your plan.
How is it, Cash?
Great.
What do you got there? We got fried chicken breast.
Fried chicken breast, some seasoned fries, and a biscuit, man. Yep. Louisiana chicken is just good.
Fire.
How it tastes, Pete?
A lot of crisp to get in there. It's good. I didn't even get to the meat yet. I'm gonna get in there.
Incoming. All that white meat.
Oh yeah, there we go. Very good.
It just snapped off.
Very good.
What do you think of this jacket, Cash?
Wow.
You like
jacket?
It?
Yeah, I love it.
The hell is that?
Great jacket.
That's my phone.
Might be an emergency.
Alert.
That's an alert.
Silver alert.
Yeah.
So Cash was talking about my jacket. I'm gonna drop an advertisement, guys. Cuts. This video is sponsored by Cuts Clothing. I've been working with Cuts for almost a year now. These are hands down the best t-shirts I've ever worn. Gone are the days of wearing a tee 10 or 20 times and then having to replace it. I've washed the tee I'm wearing in this video at least 50 times. No pilling, fading, wrinkling, or overstretched collar, and there's still plenty of life left in it. And check out the bomber jacket that I'm wearing here in Compton. Again, no wrinkle issues here. It's super high quality, stylish, and built to last. I absolutely hate shopping, so finding a brand that is quality and lasts is super important. Cuts also makes sweats and joggers that hold the same quality and style. And check out their new spring collection that just dropped. Shopping online with Cuts is easy and their customer service is rock solid. Here's a chance for you to give Cuts a try with my link below, cuts.team/Peter, and you'll get 15% off your next purchase. Again, that's cuts.team/Peter for 15% off your next purchase. Now back to the video.
The Hood Barbershop.
Yeah, my boy
Black. Compton Barber.
Yeah.
You know, in the city.
Tell me about this cut, Kaz. You go tight up here, geometric, and then you put the little angle
in. Yeah, I put the half moon in it, you know what I mean, like with the fade. And then the beard and everything. So shout out to my boy Fresh. He cut me here.
How you doing?
Right here.
Bro.
They're hooking somebody up right now.
He's going close to the skin. That's my style, man.
We in Black Spot. Me and Peter. We in Compton. Remember Brooklyn? Now we in Compton, man. Legendary hood in the city. So y'all know what it is.
Don't believe that bullshit rumor. Brooklyn don't get along with Compton.
Now y'all know.
Yeah. People can come from there here. You can go from there.
Yeah, because you know, since the Pac and Biggie and all of that, like they like New York don't mess with LA.
They spread it like it's a Compton thing in New York or Brooklyn, but it's not like that.
Y'all seeing it live and direct. This is a Compton OG. This is a Brooklyn OG.
What am I, Florida OG?
Florida OG. You worldwide, Peter.
Actually, right here, right now, this was the front entrance.
To Compton High.
This is the front entrance. You know?
Why'd they knock it down?
Remodel.
They're remodeling. Actually, I think Dr. Dre put some money into it.
Do these rappers that make it, do they give a lot back usually?
Some
of them. It depends.
Yeah, some of them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is there school choice here? Like kids can go to whatever school they want,
it's
or no?
Where you live. Here in Cali, it's the mileage range.
What would you think if your kids could go to any school? Would you be as before that or no?
What you mean?
Or you don't see the need? See, some places, like, you have school choice. Like, oh, maybe this high school is not as good as the next one over,
yeah.
And then your kids can
go
to the next one.
That's how it is in New York.
No,
yeah.
It's not out here like that.
Stay
in this community, you going to this school.
If you
stay over by Central, you going to that school.
Because even if you ain't gangbanging or nothing like that, you might be in the wrong school.
Compton's pretty much Mexican, half black, right, these days?
It got Samoans.
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 So do they segregate the schools, or is it like half and half in each?
All together.
Yeah, everybody together.
All together.
They get along for the most part?
Yeah. We have your riots.
Definitely fights. This is Fight City, Compton.
All you hear in the media is everyone's divided, right?
You don't feel that? We not divided. We all together. We have Samoans, blacks, and Mexicans, and whites.
How do they get along?
Perfect.
Seriously?
We drink together, chill together, we do everything together.
You wouldn't want to do black mat with a Samoan though, would you?
What do you think how big he is?
Amen.
You feel how big he is.
Yeah.
That's my homie pulling up on us.
Yeah, that's my boy.
He's grooving.
Bo Wacky playing that cashmere resilience.
That's some resilience, huh?
Yeah, that's resilient.
Does anyone call you Cashy?
Nah, only you.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's great.
We call him New York.
Yeah, they call me New York out here, man.
Okay,
yeah,
so guys, people ask me all this time in the comments.
Uh-huh.
Projects means what? Like, they give you rent based on how much you make?
You make, yeah.
So if you make very little, you can pay no rent.
Yeah.
My mom's paid $75 for about 10 years.
75. What's the range, you think? Anywhere 75 up to 1,000 or?
Yeah. Like I said, my mom's paid like $75 for about 10 years.
Yeah.
When she got a job, they went up.
Oh, so it's sort of like if you start making good money, then your rent goes up a lot. Rent,
it's hard to get in these places. You know, you got to go to the office, you got to go to shelters, you got to do all type of ways. You got to be on a waiting list. It's not like they're just giving these places out. And when COVID hit here, I was out here. Everybody lost their job. I was working for the city. I lost the job. And everybody lost their job.
What were you doing for the city?
I was doing like landscaping.
Parks and Recreation.
And they cut landscaping back?
It was Parks and Recreation. They
everything.
Set our parks down.
Is that why there's trash everywhere on the highways?
It was crazy trash. In New York right now, a lot of robberies and stuff because people got so used to the unemployment money and this, that, and the third. And now they're not getting it no more. So it's a lot of robberies, a lot of people desperate.
They still get it out here.
They still get it in California, right? From the state?
Yeah, you get the food stamps.
Yeah, but are all the jobs back now?
Nah.
Not all of them?
Nah.
And you're driving, right? You're delivering.
Yes, sir.
How is it in different neighborhoods right now? You see a different perspective. Most of us don't.
Yeah.
Right. So what's it like?
Certain neighborhoods, some people hesitate. Then they want you to sign for them. I can't sign for you. You got to open your door and let me in. And then some neighborhoods, it's more welcoming, but a lot of people are friendly.
What's the most unwelcoming neighborhood in greater Los Angeles?
Oh, no, I'm about to deliver order. It might get me.
No.
Beverly Hills.
Like, I knocked on a lady's door one time, right? And she got a driver, but he black. She used to him coming to her door all the time. So she thought I was him, threw her camera, opened the door, and she hollered. Ah! I'm like, what's wrong with you? She's like, I'm sorry. It's panic. I thought you was the other driver. But she was very apologetic, but that's how people shook up nowadays, though.
Yeah.
You know why people shook up, though? Because I can go buy a FedEx UPS uniform from the store. Hey, I can knock on your door. I can go to Beverly Hills, you know, Hollywood, Brentwood.
Right.
Hey, I got a package for you. You want to show me your door? Lay down. I'm coming there with a gun. You know what I'm saying? Give me all that.
That's happening right now?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
How's FedEx these days? They treat you guys well?
Oh, yeah, they treat me well. Yeah.
Is there a lot of job openings in FedEx right now? Drivers?
Jobs everywhere right now. Jobs in high demand. So if you want a job, you want a job. Some people just choose not to work.
Right. Yeah. They getting all that unemployment money.
What's going on here?
This is the apartment I stayed in when I first came out here.
What's your name? I'm sorry.
It's a lot going on.
It's Cashmere.
Taiwan, you can tell.
Okay.
Taiwan? You go by Taiwan?
Yeah, that's my real name.
Who's this lady to Cash?
She's Samoan. That's Cash's ex-wife mom.
Oh.
This is my kid's grandmother.
Oh. What's your name?
Vignetta.
Peter.
Yeah, this is my
son-in-law. do you miss Cash?
Yeah.
You miss him a little?
Yeah, I miss him.
just out here. Cash is a superstar.
Yeah, no. we're doing some
Yeah, he's a well-known guy.
Yeah.
His music.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I shouldn't have said that, guy. No, yeah. Man, he's doing terrible. Nobody knows him.
Come over here.
Right here, these are they Mexican. They push their basket around selling sodas, ice cream, water, candy bars, you know, whatever you want. They go around the whole neighborhood, like every hour.
Delivery.
Yeah, every
delivery.
Hour.
That's my original name.
Taiwan?
Yeah.
Cashmere's his rap name.
Yeah, that's my rap name, Cashmere.
You don't tell me these secrets, mm-hmm. Cash. Muchas gracias.
Thank you. No matter your race, you just gotta support the people. You know what I mean? Let the homies know, make sure they safe. Don't rob them. They just are trying to make an honest living.
They've been here for a long, long time.
Long time.
So they're well protected. Like, nobody gives them problems. Hey, bye-bye.
Nobody better not fuck with them.
They doing it the right way.
Can you support them and you probably don't got no money to give you something for free?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why you look out for them. I give them a generous tip.
If somebody fuck with them, then we gotta come over here and go get at that dude that did it. He gonna get a shit back plus.
It's a very diverse neighborhood right here, so
yeah.
The politics ain't there. We're not racist.
Content of character, right? MLK's
exactly.
Message.
That's how you carry yourself.
Yeah, and respect go two ways. Like I said just now before you cut the camera on, right? Just because we agree with something and you don't make you a racist.
Racist.
Because of your skin. Everything not racially motivated.
One thing I be hating is like, we be, you know, killing each other some in the hood and stuff like that. Where I'm from, where everybody's from, all over the world. But then when a cop kill a black, it's like, you know, some is for wrong cause or whatever, however, but when this person killed that person over something stupid that we all know in the circle, then we let it slide. And not only do we let it slide, we perpetuate it sometimes for it to go on.
Right? We are hanging out, drinking my hand, right? 90% of the cops that patrol my community never been in my community. So 9 times out of 10 when they get it, they scared.
They scared.
So they put a gun on me right now and tell me, put my hands up. I'm gonna do what they tell me to do until they feel like they safe. And if I wanna talk shit and feel it's racially motivated, I'm gonna talk shit. I'm not gonna run. They automatically think I got a gun on me. They shoot me in the back. Sometimes they be scared. It could be other things that don't make it racist all the time. Some of it is, some of it not. Sometimes you give them an excuse. Right? If you come somewhere, place a community, you never grew around black people, and we already got a bad reputation on ourselves, and we already stereotyped, when he pull up and put a gun out, I'm going to do what he say do instead of doing something dumb, because I know he might be scared already.
Yeah, my
and
grandfather told me that early.
And then I'm dead.
Shoot you out of panic.
And then all this fake love come out because some people want to get money off of it.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you mean by that?
You got activists, though, like, if I get killed right now, activists are going to come to the hood, but ain't nothing over here right now and understanding our struggle for right now. It's people over there that need.
Where are the BLM summer camps for kids?
Where's the community centers? Where's the free lunch? Where's the, for the kids? It used to be like that back in the days, but now it seems like they took all of that away.
Do things for the community, the kids won't grow up a certain way. Where the people at that got the resources for us at before something happened? Why you not here now? You can prevent stuff from happening, right?
So the kids go to school Monday through Friday,
and then you can have some extra activities for the kids on the weekend so they won't be out hanging out looking at
that. So what do you guys need? What are you saying you need? You see more resources for kids? Or what?
Yeah, you got to start with the youth because it's too late for us.
Community center.
It's too late for
the
us.
The youth is everything.
What about the fathers? What's your take on that?
Coming up, I used to think that like a lot of fathers didn't want to be fathers. There was a lot of deadbeats. But I think the government got some design to get the fathers out the home.
What do you mean by that?
You grow up from nothing. So you got to go on welfare or get government assistance in some shape, form, or fashion. So then it's designed. If you need that, the father got to be out the home.
The welfare only works if the father's out of the home?
Yes, you only get, not all, but if you marry.
It's not about getting a father out the home so they can accept welfare.
Yeah.
They can put the daddy on the plan as well, like he's here. Because if you get the daddy out the house, now you got to pay child support.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? If your moms go to the county and say, where the daddy at? Or I don't know, all the time he living there. Now, you're going to get stuck with child support.
Mm-hmm.
The county allow you to say, yes, the daddy here, he's taking care of them. And y'all are a family.
A family, yeah.
You know what I mean? They won't bother you.
But in a lot of cases,
they won't bother you.
I think a lot of fathers missing out of home for selfish reasons, right? Too much temptation. see that something that you want besides what you already got, and then when you go to the next woman, she don't want to allow you to deal with your kids or whatever, and then we go along with it. My kids can't, no woman keep me from my kids.
You're right.
Not at all. They're mine. So you got to settle with my package.
I'll stay here with you.
I might not be in a home with them, but I'm going to take care of them to my best ability.
Yeah.
Tell her I got a girl, right? She can. She might want my girl spot, but I got a girl, but it's up to me to decide if I cheat or not. And then when you cheat, she wants that number one spot, and then half the kids come along. It's about a missing daddy, but it's not, because you should have chose to protect yourself. You know what I mean?
Who should have told her to protect themselves?
We should have protected ourselves. As a man, I should protect myself. Even if I cheat on my girl, I should protect myself and not have no baby outside of my relationship. So father missing because you didn't have a baby by a girl that you really had no intention of being with. And then now my girl at home, like, you can't be a part of baby life. You didn't have a baby out of a relationship. If you set me for having a baby, you still want to be with me, I'm still got to take care of my child. As far as me as a man. Yeah, that's mine.
Okay, we can help. You got to park.
How, you want the keys to move it?
No.
You can bring it back to me. You know what I'm saying?
But you think...
He only does valet parking.
Wow,
you ain't partying.
We're going to come right now.
Yeah.
We're going to come right now.
But yeah, like, so...
But you think that's cool for the mothers to keep the father
cool
out the line?
No, but it ain't cool for that. But some of the stuff we do ain't cool neither. That's why we got some a lot of fatherless kids out here.
Some women do it out of jealousy or hate.
Bitterness and
stuff
like that.
Oh, you with that girl, but, you know, you ain't here with me.
Right.
Like, because he chose, hey, like dude, say, he chose to cheat.
Hey, if I give you, you got to give me a ride at least.
Definitely.
It's complicated.
See, it's complicated. And then at the end, you know, I feel like the child's relationship with his father doesn't have nothing to do with the mother. And even if they go their separate ways, whatever happened between them personally, that the mother should always let a father inside their child's life. If you're not, then that's kind of crazy. And unfortunately, that's what goes on a lot around in our community. Like, you got to deal with those consequences depending on what kind of woman you with.
Come on, here we go, I'm about to do it again. Took so many losses that I'm due for a win. I ain't perfect, first to tell you that I am human. Though I'm blessed by God, but still I sin. About to go all out, hear me black on this beat. Should have been it, but now I'm the heart of the street. Every time I close my eyes, all I see is the east. Been through so
full
much,
circle,
all
guys.
I pray for is peace. But you know about your next keeping you from the kids. Guns in 10 years, why you fighting me big? Nah, this ain't really
somebody. Is that your little one?
Yeah, that's
Oh,
fine.
Cute.
You kiss. Say hi.
Okay. Okay to be on camera?
Yeah, we good.
Hey, let's go to Delamo Swap Meet.
We need a Compton sweatshirt and a black marker for you guys to sign.
Gotcha. Yeah,
for
gotcha.
My wife, yeah, Natalia, yeah. That said I have to get BK Cash's signature on a Compton sweatshirt.
Fan, so I appreciate Natalia a lot.
She edits your videos, man.
Yeah, I know. We here, man, just chilling, sipping. It's a Sunday. Football games is on. We in the hood outside watching. We about to go to the Delamo Swap Meet. That's like the hood mall. So y'all gonna see it. We gonna get what you. We gonna see that. You know, we got Lil Wack with us. I've been in this game for years. It made me an animal. It was rules to the shit. I wrote me a manual.
Yeah, step by step booklet for you to get your game on point. Check your feelings joint. I ain't Biggie, but I came to get busy.
Yeah.
Straight out the east where we bang and get drippy. I'm talking Uncle Murder, I'm talking about FN and BK Cashmere. Nah, y'all can't forget him.
Let's go.
Cause I birthed it, made it up in earth.
What are we pulling up to now?
Swap meet. Some people call it Fleetwood Mall. We call it Swap Meet out here in Compton.
So it's not about Walmart here, huh?
Nah.
This is massive, guys. Got everything.
Everything.
It's the hood nigga mall.
Yeah.
It's very clean in here. You got a food.
You can get a haircut here.
The tattoos parlor over there, you get massages. Most homies come get their tattoos at. You do like mostly everything.
So this is your tattoo shop?
Yeah,
Okay, so what are you doing? Everything, a little bit of everything.
Tattoo, piercing.
Could you tattoo this beautiful face on my calf?
Yeah.
What's up, man?
Yeah.
What's up? We got a drink hot dog shop. How you doing?
Yeah, man.
I'm the manager here.
Okay. Yeah. How is it surviving with Walmart and Amazon and all these other places?
Just pretty much the community that likes to shop here. They seem to be more comfortable here. They like the
old school feeling here, and just a sense that they can go to a store and actually talk to the owner.
These are all local business owners in here, everyone.
They're all kind of mom and pop stores, so small businesses. Most of the stores here, the owners run them. But we were shut down for 5 months, so it was definitely a struggle. You know, some of the big stores were able to stay open. They called them the essential businesses.
How is that they're like Walmart's essential, but you're not?
I don't know. Yeah,
that's crazy.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
That was crazy. To me, didn't make any sense, because this is what builds community and keeps community,
right?
Is businesses that, you know, are from here and give to here. And when you take those out, then where's the community, right?
Exactly.
So, Mr. Who?
Mr. Kim.
Mr. Kim set you up?
Yeah, I got Long Beach shirts and don't got no Compton sweater.
He said it was right here, but
wait. Cash, I'm going to have to delete this video if we go to Compton, but can't get a Compton sweatshirt.
This one.
Okay.
This one and this one.
What about this one up there?
Oh, straight out of Compton?
Yeah. I have those too, yeah.
You have a straight out of Compton sweatshirt?
Some people like it.
Okay.
Just got Natalia two straight out of Compton hoodies. Largest.
Why large?
Because women love large. They like the bulky look, and they could wear that. They could wear that.
I was going somewhere else with it, but yeah. You got it.
Miss Lim, is that the right one? Yeah.
Medium.
Okay.
All right.
Fantastic.
I want both.
Thank you, Miss Lim.
Do you have a boyfriend?
I have a couple.
A couple?
Yeah.
Why don't you be the third?
You said a couple.
I didn't say how many. How are you going to
be? You said a couple
third?
Is two.
No, it's not.
Oh, yeah.
Do you mind? You mind being number three? You okay with that?
I'm fine. I ain't got no problem with it. Well, it's gonna be like
Mrs. Lynn, what do you think of this?
Okay.
That's disrespectful. That ain't disrespecting right there on the stop sign. That's disrespectful.
Who disrespected her?
Chief Flats. They crossed out.
That's Bloods.
Chief Flats is a Mexican gang.
Okay. Hola.
That's normal. They got a trail out here for them. That's normal right here. You can rent them if you want. You can go right now and ride a horse.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hola.
What's up?
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah. Turn me up a little bit, just a little bit more.
Yeah.
For the East, man. Turn me up a little bit. A little bit more.
What's up? What's up?
Feel like I met this guy.
He's definitely.
How you doing, Peter?
Man.
Yeah. Peter, nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you, bro.
Yeah, you too.
We got some Compton sweatshirts for Natalia that we gonna sign. We got you three Compton hat too. We just want to say thank you. I thank you for everything that you've been to Peter and the support that you've been giving me.
So
we just gonna sign them.
Nuki Lope.
Nuki's in here. OG Bones.
Yeah, that's OG Bones. He's been around about 50 some years.
How's OG Bones done on the mat?
Oh, he's A1.
Certified,
bona fide, qualified.
Boax in here.
Wack with a WA, we put two C's.
Two C's.
From Compton, we don't use no K's on the front of our C's. We're gonna get Natalia this hat right here.
Yeah. Oh, that's so cool.
Appreciate the love from Peter for coming to the hood, showing some good publicity.
Real.
No gang violence, though, the good part of the hood, the struggles.
Like I'm trying to shirt,
it's good that somebody come through without the gang violence and just something positive.
Thank you, Boax. Thank you.
This
is girl's shirt. Yeah, she won a concert.
That's my wife. She actually, she makes a lot of these videos. She does like a lot of the work.
What's your name?
Peter.
Peter? Yeah, my boy just told me you official.
Official, okay,
yeah,
cool.
He just told me you official. My homie just told me you official.
Tell you, I ain't trying to get no brownie points, though.
Nah, we don't do brownie points.
No brownie points.
No brownie points.
Nah, we don't do that.
Nah, thanks for this, you guys.
No brownie points. See, that's that 82 shit. Yeah,
well, 82 shit? Like 1982?
He was like 13 or something, you know?
Like 10. Right.
Let y'all get a bar of this right here.
Sign the sleeves,
all that shit. Sign that bitch up.
What's the X mean, though?
It
mean
disrespect.
I mean,
it's a disrespect.
Bones crossed it out.
No, don't do that, man. We all peace around here.
So can we do the non-X, though, so I don't get her in trouble walking down the street and somehow?
She's going to say, I crossed it out because of Brooklyn.
Don't get me involved in that bullshit.
Okay, guys, that's the end of the road today.
Yeah.
Peek into Compton.
Yeah.
Thank you, BK Cashmere.
Yes, we're Brooklyn Zone. I'm chilling with the Compton's finest, my boy Nuke Boax. Y'all L back there, my boy Darren.
We just, Nuke.
We wrapping it up. Do.
Thanks for bringing us around, showing us the ins and outs.
Not a
problem. Nuke's neighborhood that he grew up in. I'm going to leave these guys' social media links below.
Yeah.
Nuke's in there, and also BK Cashmere, who makes amazing music. You got to listen to it. The music in this video was from Cash.
Yeah.
He's on the up big time. Yeah. Listen to his stuff.
Definitely. Check it out. Resilience is out there.
He just didn't drink on camera.
He didn't drink on camera. But we got my boy Yael right here too, man. Compton's finest, doing his thing and everything. We got Shine back there.
Yeah, man.
Compton's finest, man. This is how we do all the way from Brooklyn. Shout out to my guys though. Shout out to Compton's. I'm repping my guys today because if it wasn't for them, if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be able to do what I do right now, you know what I mean? So I salute my guys right here, Compton's Finest, Park Village,
Brooklyn,
I know what it
house.
Is. Brooklyn in the house and everything. Resilience is out now, y'all go Brooklyn. Check it out. Yael got something going on. Go ahead, talk your
Talk something, y'all. Blue Flame Project coming soon, man. I got a Blue Flame Project.
We're gonna get his links under it too. So y'all
links
can check
galore
it out.
Down
and,
below.
And most and foremost, shout out to Peter, shout out to Natalia. I love you guys. I appreciate you guys for coming out,
and
showing love. We out of here, man. Y'all check it out.
Peace.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for coming along. Till the next one.
Yeah.
All right, guys. There's one last thing I want to say. Quite often in the comments in these videos, the ones I've done in East New York or the other South Central video I did, I try to show it in the video. I try to convey it through the visuals, but I never outright say it. And what that is, look, obviously there are problems, obviously, you know, things aren't perfect. I'm not trying to act like it is, but there's a thing that they have in these communities that often goes overlooked, that being the connection, the community, the togetherness. I don't think any of these guys are ever alone. They're pretty much with the guys they grew up with since day one. And there's something special in that. It feels like a different world out here to say where I'm staying in Santa Monica. And there, things feel more fractured. People are more on their own in general. And here, despite the problems, despite the crime, despite what goes on, there's a brotherhood. And that's very human. Something I think everybody wants in life. I also want to say a lot of these guys are quite smart. They have high emotional intelligence, obviously street smarts. Like, you have to know your surroundings. You have to understand the lay of the land. You can't be complacent or lazy with that. It's because I don't think you'll survive. You won't do well. And so when I'm hanging out with these guys, while many of them didn't go to college, they're very smart and I enjoy it. It's really complex. You know, none of this is, you can't say Compton is like this or Watts is like there. These people are like that exactly. Like, it's the human condition is messy and mixed up, and you can't put an easy label on any of this. Hope you enjoyed that, guys. It was really fun to make, and we'll see you on the next one. Bye.